In hip-hop, it feels like there's a constant battle for some kind of supremacy. Who's the greatest rapper alive? Who are the top 5 rap lyricists ever? Who's the GOAT? All that kind of stuff. Within a rapper's discography, there are a few commonalities that might get your name in the conversation. Do you have, say, 5 or more albums that are considered great by most music fans? I'd say that's true for this guy, and this guy, too. When you put out so many masterpieces, you're gonna be talked about as an all-time great. There's no question about it. Or maybe your music declined a little bit as the years went on, but the albums that put your name on the map are great enough to keep your legacy going forever. I'm not gonna sit here and keep naming examples because we'll be here all day, but I want to make this point. Anyone in the conversation for greatest rapper of all time probably has at least 2 or 3 classic hip-hop albums. Today we're going to be talking about someone who was once hailed as the future savior of rap, somebody whose name was surely going to be in the conversation for the GOAT, and he's never released a studio album. This is an introduction to Jay Electronica. In 1976, Timothy Thedford was born in the Magnolia Projects of New Orleans. As a teenager, he was inspired by his uncle to start rapping, and by age 19 in 1995, Timothy left Louisiana to pursue his dreams of music, where he would go by the stage name of Jay Electronica. For the next few years, he was pretty much homeless, sleeping on couches and traveling from New York to Philly, Baltimore, Denver, Atlanta, and everywhere in between. He was performing at whatever club or stage would allow him in, doing whatever he could to make it as a musician. Eventually, in the mid-2000s, Jay made his way over to Detroit, where he started finding some success. He made friends that were pretty high up in the Detroit rap scene, and that led him to close relationships with the legendary hip-hop producer Jay Dilla, and former member of Eminem's rap group D12, Mr. Porter. This is when the first real, official songs from Jay started to get released. He rapped over some beats from Jay Dilla, asked him if he could release the songs as a demo tape, and that's what led us to 2007's Style Wars. While this demo didn't really blow up or anything when it first came out, it's a great introduction to Jay's unique style. Incredible flows, a barrage of clever lyrics where half of the wordplay is gonna fly over your head on the first listen, and nobody's gonna complain about production from Jay Dilla, either. Here's a snippet from the song, So What You Saying. Every page of my poetry's like a rhyme from the clip. The mic is always in my holster right on top of my hip. Shortly after recording Style Wars, Jay Electronica released Act 1, Eternal Sunshine, The Pledge, on his MySpace page. This thing, whatever you want to call it, is unbelievable. It's a 15-minute project, or just one big song, that's broken into 5 distinct sections. It opens with a section of legendary producer Just Blaze and then iconic neo-soul singer Erykah Badu just talking about how unique and special Jay's musical abilities are. From then on out, it's Jay rapping, but there's no drums or beats on this entire project. The whole thing is just bits and pieces of John Bryan's score for Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, and then occasionally some audio bites from Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. I can firmly say that this piece of music changed my life. I had never heard anything like it before, and honestly, there hasn't been anything like it since. He makes these complex rhymes and flows seem so easy. Conceptually, Act 1 is so inventive, courageous, and weird, it's no wonder why Noisy called it an idiosyncratically beautiful, timeless classic. She said she never fell in love with a Superman, Christian, Muslim, Protestant, Lutheran. I told her that being immortal. With the release of Act 1, people started paying attention to this incredibly skillful rapper, and with people first finding out about Jay, they started playing Style Wars too. He was probably the most talked about rapper of 2008, and now everybody wanted more Jay Electronica music. But as Hip Hop DX wrote about him in 2008, Jay Electronica was at times more like a myth or urban legend than an actual rapper. As soon as he started blowing up, Jay pretty much turned into a ghost. He started talking about the release of his debut studio album Act 2, Patents of Nobility, went to Africa and Asia to film for it, but for all of the new Jay Electronica fans of the world, things started getting frustrating. With the release of tracks called Exhibit A and Exhibit C in 2009, people thought we were getting closer to Act 2, but in reality, this was the beginning of a pattern for Jay and his releases. Months would go by without any word from him, and then he would release a solo track. Time goes on, people are begging for the album, and he releases another solo track. But then in 2010, fans found new hope because Jay Electronica signed with Jay-Z's record label, Roc Nation. That means the album has to be coming soon, right? Because, like, contracts would not allow him to just keep releasing song after song and not releasing the album, right? Wrong. It's been a decade since Jay Electronica announced his debut studio album, and there's not much to show for it. Every year or so, there would be these random scattered releases of songs, but the actual album never came. He would go in and out of the limelight whenever he felt like it. In 2013, he was featured on one of my favorite Mac Miller songs of all time, Suplexes, Inside of Complexes and Duplexes. That same year, he was featured on Big Sean's Control, which was that song where Kendrick called out every major rapper in the game, so that definitely overshadowed Jay reappearing in the spotlight. 2014 saw the release of the song Better in Tune with the Infinite, which I really do love. 2015 saw a track called Road to Perdition with Jay-Z. 2016 saw him featured on Chance the Rapper's Coloring Book, then teasing something big, and it was just another song. In 2017, he dropped a track because he was inspired by Kevin Durant's double-double in the NBA Finals, and that's the last time we've heard new music from him. In the decade since he announced an album, we've heard more than a few tracks from him, some guest features, we've got the track list, and he says the whole thing has been finished for years and he's played it for people. But still to this day, no Act 2. While I can't guarantee why he never released the album, I can give you my personal opinion. Jay is a very spiritual man. He's heavily involved with the Nation of Islam, and it seems like Jay makes decisions in life based on the vibes he's feeling. If music doesn't seem important to him for a few months, then he'll leave the country, go find himself for a while, and come back. The deal he signed with Roc Nation probably seems irrelevant to him, whether or not they've been suing him for breach of contract. Besides that, if I'm trying to find excuses for him, he's had some interesting ups and downs in his love life. I'm not gonna get into it, and it doesn't seem like a real reason to not release an album that's been done for years, but I figured it's worth mentioning. So, with all that being said, the story of Jay Electronica is a weird one. From the songs he has released, his technical rapping ability, lyricism, flow, wordplay, all of those things are on par with the greatest rappers of all time. Listen to Jay's song, The Announcement. I didn't want to put a snippet in because I want you to listen to that track, open up Genius, get the lyrics going, and go through each and every line. It's unbelievable. But with somebody that is that talented, for whatever reason, he just kind of stopped. I feel like you can sum up his career with that riffraff vine that goes,
"My main goal is to blow up and then act like I don't know nobody."
I don't know if we'll ever get Act 2, but now that you know the story of Jay Electronica, maybe we can try and talk him into it. He goes on Twitter every now and then, so tweet at him, tell him you love and appreciate his music, and that we'd all be really grateful if he dropped this album for us. Hey, thank you for watching that video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. That stuff is easy and it does help the channel. If you want to support me in any other ways, you can follow me on social media at RenshawHS. You can buy my merch, support my Patreon. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon.